Good morning, students. This is for BTech 6M TT TCT students under the subject Textile Testing 2. And we have discussed in the last lecture various terminology related to tensile testing of fibers and yarns. And we have studied the relation between linear density and diameter of fiber, as shown here also, that how we can convert diameter to linear density using the formula of density, using the density. We have already discussed in lecture 1 what is the meaning of packing factor and how it is related to specific volume of fiber and yarn and density of the yarn. We'll understand one more term here, porosity, which is basically 1 minus packing fraction. Porosity gives us an idea about the amount of air, still air present in the yarn, and which is equal to 1 minus packing fraction. This is also we have studied in the last lecture, the meaning of tensile strength and tenacity, where tensile strength is stress at break and tenacity is specific stress at break. Now, how we move from tensile strength to tenacity in different numericals? We have studied this relation in last class, and we'll do some gate numericals based on these formulas. Now, the first one here is we have to calculate the denier of a fiber where diameter is given as 21 microns and the fiber density is also given 1.3 gram per cc. Now, we know that density is equal to linear density upon area. We have to calculate denier, which we will calculate from linear density in gram per centimeter. So first we'll calculate area, which is pi d square upon 4. That is the formula for circular cross section. And then we'll calculate linear density using the density in gram per cc, which is given here. So we now, after getting the linear density in gram per centimeter, we change it to denier by multiplying by 9 and into 10 to the power 5. So we'll get 4.04 denier. Now this is the next numerical. When denier of fiber is doubled, its diameter increases by. Now we'll try to understand the relation between linear density and diameter. From the given formula, it is obvious that linear density is directly proportional to dia square, and using the formula of proportionality, we get that d2 is basically 1.414 times d1. Next question. In this question, we are given the diameter of cotton fiber, cotton yarn of 50 tex in mm. Yeah. And packing density is 0.45, assuming cotton fiber density 1.54, we have to find the diameter of cotton yarn. So yarn density is equal to packing density into fiber density. So first we'll calculate the value of yarn density, and then using the relation of density, linear density and area, we'll calculate area. And then we'll calculate the diameter using the formula of pi d square by 4 of the circular yarn cross section. So we get here dia is equal to 0.303 mm. Okay, now in the next question, the surface area per unit volume of a circular polyester fiber of 1.5 denier fineness and 1.38 cc, ignoring the fiber edges. Now in this question, basically we have to find surface area per unit volume. Assuming polyester fiber to be cylindrical, if we ignore the fiber ends, so then we get surface area is basically 2 pi rh and volume is pi r square h. So the ratio will be equal to 2 upon r. Now we have to calculate the radius of the fiber, and that we can calculate through this relation of density, linear density and diameter. And after that we'll calculate radius, diameter divided by 2, and then we calculate this specific surface area, which is 2 upon r. So the final answer is 322.48 millimeter inverse. Next, we'll move on to next question. That is, a 225 denier viscose yarn has a breaking strength of 7.5 newtons. And we have to calculate the yarn tenacity in centinewton per decitex. So first we have to convert the newtons into centinewtons. So 7.5 will be 750 centinewtons. Next, 225 denier is converted to tex. That is 25 tex and then 250 decitex. So if we get here as tenacity in centinewton per decitex is 3. 3 is the final answer. Next question related to this topic is a cotton fiber of, this is an interesting question, a cotton fiber of 180 millitex has a density of 1.5 gram per centimeter cube and average perimeter of 40 micrometer. Average area of the cell wall in micrometer square is. Now here first we'll find the area using this relation of density, linear density and area. So we have been given the linear density 180 millitex and density is also given. So we'll find the area, that is 120 micrometer square. Now next question is a needle punched non-woven fabric has 2 mm thickness and 400 gram per meter square areal density. If the fiber density is 0.9 gram per centimeter cube, we have to calculate the volume porosity percent. Now we know porosity is equal to 1 minus packing factor, and packing factor is the ratio of the specific volume of fiber to that of fabric in the present case, and specific volume is inverse of density. So first we'll calculate the density of the fabric using mass upon volume, where the formula changes to areal density upon thickness here. Next, we'll calculate the specific volume of the fabric, which is inverse of density. Next, we'll calculate the packing fraction, which is the ratio of the specific volume of the fiber and the fabric. And then porosity is equal to 1 minus packing fraction, and which is, if we express it is in percentage, that we'll get 77.77%. The next question in this relation, in this matter is the breaking load of a 300 millitex fiber is 110 millinewton. If the density of the fiber is given and we have to calculate the breaking stress in kilonewton per centimeter square. So here we have to go from tenacity to tensile strength. And we are given force and we are given linear density. So we'll use the formula of going from linear density to area using the density of the material, and then breaking force divided by area will give me will give us tensile strength in the required units, which is 45.45 kilonewton per centimeter square. Now the next question related to this is, the fiber packing density in a cotton bale of 170 kg weight and dimensions are given, length, width and the height, assuming cotton fiber density to be 1.54 gram per cc. Now packing density is ratio of specific volume to that of fiber to that of bale in this question, and specific volume is inverse of density, so we can write the formula in terms of density also, and we get the packing density as 0.25. The next question related to this topic is, the coefficient of correlation between packing density and porosity of a set of yarn is, it is minus 1 because the packing density plus porosity is equal to 1, which is a linear equation. So when packing density increases, porosity decreases. So coefficient of correlation is minus 1. That is, they are inversely related to each other. Now the next question related to this is, 4 grams of polyester fiber of 1.5 denier with fiber density is given, is packed in chamber to make a 2 centimeter long plug of 3 centimeter diameter. Calculate the porosity. Now we have to calculate porosity, which is 1 minus packing factor. Packing factor is ratios of densities, and density of the plug we can find out by using mass per unit volume, and for volume we have to use the formula of volume of cylinder, that is pi r square h, and then we find the packing factor and porosity. Now the last question related to this is to convert initial modulus, which is in the units of gram force per text, 350 grams of gram force per text, to that in units of GPA of polyester fiber. Here also we'll move through the density. Density is given, that is 1.35 gram per cc, and we have to move from initial modulus in gram force per text to initial modulus in GPA, where G is giga, which is 10 to power 9, and PA is Pascal, which is also Newton per meter square. So the required calculations are shown here, and we'll get the answer at 4.63 GPA. Okay, thank you. Now we'll meet in next class. Thank you.